Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
The modality of, let's call it, spiritual healing, I know you don't like the word psychic, but I use it a lot, psychic healing, could be applied to society as a whole.
Yes, not only could, but has been. Mm-hmm. But people don't recognize it often. The idea that if you start from Planck's, let's start there. If you start with Planck's dictum, consciousness is the fundamental. Mm-hmm. You cannot get behind consciousness. Materiality arises from consciousness, not consciousness from materiality. Mm-hmm. If you can accept that concept, or Einstein's description of reality as an optical delusion, or Heisenberg or Schrodinger or Pauli, all of these men who really are the fathers of modern physics. The interesting thing is we embrace their equations, but we don't embrace their conclusions. And all of them were very significantly influenced by a 19th century polymath named Adolf Bastian, who created what he called the idea of the elementary thoughts of humanity. Mm. And that's where Jung got the idea of the collective unconscious.
I see.
And that's where Joe Campbell got the idea of the monomyth. Hmm. This idea that all consciousness is interdependent and interconnected. Mm-hmm. Well, if you begin from that premise, or if you accept the possibility of that premise.
Which is, I understand, what the mystics of every culture have basically
said. Of course.
Said.
Yes. And if we tend to associate these things with religion, inappropriately, in my view, mm-hmm. whenever you hear the word spiritual, if you put the word non-local in its non-local consciousness,
yeah.
I think you'll be a much more accurate, because mm-hmm. religions are all man-made, and they all start from a non-local consciousness experience. Every religion mm-hmm. begins, someone has a non-local consciousness experience, whether it's Jesus or Buddha, or Lao Tzu, or anybody else. They mm-hmm. have a non-local consciousness experience.
In other words, consciousness larger than themselves.
They have a sense that they are connected with and are receiving guidance from a greater unity than their own personality.
There are many words for this. Sometimes it's called cosmic consciousness.
Cosmic consciousness, omega, logos. There are lots mm-hmm. of ways to describe this. Because what happens is, in every one of these cases, someone has this experience, and they talk about it. And if they are charismatic enough as a personality, and if the timing is right, because the thing about genius and spiritual epiphanies are that the initiating experience is individual, but only social acceptance makes them a manifest phenomena.
Mm-hmm.
So people have to hear it, and then they're moved by it.
Yep.
They're quickened by it in some way. So the cultural timing has to mm-hmm. be right. You know, if you have the experience too early, you're just a crank.
Yeah.
It's social timing and individual experience have got to match.
Mm-hmm.
And when they do, then you get these movements. But they are described as spiritual because they are contextualized in the idea of some divinity.
Mm-hmm. Or the idea that we're all sort of surrounded by spirit.
Yes, by which we're saying consciousness.
Yes.